Commander, Zimbabwe National Army, Acting Commander, Air Force of Zimbabwe, General Officers, and Senior Officers, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I do not leave you members of the press welcome. Let us begin by quoting the constitution of this country, particularly the preamble, which speaks of, and I quote, exalting and extolling the brave men and women who sacrificed their lives during the Chimurenga Umuvikera and national liberation struggles, and honoring our forebears and compatriots who toiled for the progress of our country, unquote. It is with humility and a heavy heart that we come before you to pronounce the indisputable reality that there is instability in ZANU-PF today, and as a result, anxiety in the country at large. Zimbabwe's history is hinged on the ideals of the revolution dating to the first Chimurenga, where thousands of people perished. ZANU-PF is the political party that waged the second Chimurenga for our independence. The struggle in which many Zimbabweans, in one way or the other, sacrificed and contributed immensely for our liberation. Many of these gallant fighters still live on with the spirited hope of seeing a prosperous Zimbabwe, but also the hope of leaving behind inheritance and legacy for posterity. It is pertinent to restate that the Zimbabwe Defense Forces remain the major stockholder in respect to the gains of the liberation struggle. And when these are threatened, we are obliged to take corrective measures. Clearly, ZANU-PF, having mainly been the only party that has ruled this country since independence, it has become a household name to most Zimbabweans across political divide. Therefore, it is common cause that any instability within the party naturally impacts on their social, political, and economic lives. Accordingly, there is distress, trepidation, and despondence within the nation. Our peace-loving people who have stood by their government and endured some of the most trying social and economic conditions ever experienced are extremely disturbed by what is happening within the ranks of the National Revolutionary Party. What is obtaining in the Revolutionary Party is a direct result of the machinations of counter-revolutionaries who have infiltrated the party and whose agenda is to destroy it from within. It is saddening to see our revolution being hijacked by agents of our erstwhile enemies, who are now at the brink of returning our country to foreign domination, against which so many of our people perished. The famous slogan espoused by His Excellency the President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, Head of State and Government and Commander-in-Chief of the Zimbabwe Defense Forces, Comrade Robert Gabriel Mugabe, and I quote, "Zimbabwe will never be a colony again," unquote, is being seriously challenged by counter-revolutionary infiltrators who are now effectively influencing the direction of the party. It is our strong and deeply considered position that if drastic action is not taken immediately, our beloved country, Zimbabwe, is definitely headed to becoming a neo-colony again. The current purging and cleansing process in ZANU-PF, which so far is targeting mostly members associated with our liberation history, is a serious cause of concern to us in the defense forces. As a result of squabbling within the ranks of ZANU-PF, there has been no meaningful development in the country for the past 5 years. The resultant economic impasse has ushered in more challenges to the Zimbabwean populace, such as cash shortages and rising commodity prices. Our revolutionary path is replete with conduct and rebellion by people who have attempted to destroy the revolution from within. The formation of Floris, the attempt to remove the late Comrade Chitepo from his position as chairman at the Mumbwa Bogus Congress in 1973. The Nari Bazaar Rebellion. The Banik Story Rebellion, soon after the death of Comrade Chitepo. The Bashandi 1 and 2, as well as the rebellion that led to the death of the late Zipra commander, Comrade Alfred Nikita Mangena. Among others are cases in point. Therefore, the current shenanigans by people who do not share the same liberation history of ZANU-PF party are not a surprise to us. But what is significant to us and the generality of Zimbabweans is to remember that all these rebellions were diffused by the military. But at no point did the military usurp power. We must remind those behind the current treacherous shenanigans that when it comes to matters of protecting our revolution, the military will not hesitate to step in. ZANU-PF's standing political virtues are a product of faithful adherence to the founding values, decorum, discipline, and revolutionary protocol in the ruling party. Party orders were strictly adhered to, and whatever differences existed, they were resolved amicably and in the ruling party's closet. Unfortunately, since the turn of 2015, ZANU-PF's traditional protocol and procedures have changed with a lot of gossiping, backbiting, and public chastisement being the order of the day. Indeed, the party is undoing its legacy built over the years. While our people may be persuaded to take what is going on in ZANU-PF as internal political matters in that party, the truth remains that ZANU-PF's conduct and behavior as a ruling party has a direct impact on the lives of every citizen. Hence, all of us, regardless of political affiliation, are affected by the party's manner of doing business. From a security point of view, we cannot ignore the experiences of countries such as Somalia, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Central African Republic, and many others in our region, where minor political differences degenerate into serious conflict that has decimated the social, political, and economic security of ordinary people. Section 212 of the Constitution of Zimbabwe mandates the Zimbabwe Defense Forces to protect Zimbabwe, its people, its national security and interest, and its territorial integrity, and to uphold this constitution. Among other security threats that are coming out of what is obtaining ZANU-PF are the reckless utterances by politicians denigrating the military, which are causing despondence within the rank and file. Further, we note with concern the attempts by some politicians to drive a wedge between the security services for their own selfish interests. This is unacceptable. We take great exception to this behavior. There is only one commander-in-chief, His Excellency the President, Head of State and Government, and Commander-in-Chief of the Zimbabwe Defense Forces, Comrade Robert Gabriel Mugabe. The military is an institution whose roles cut across in the wider spectrum of government support functions in the form of military aid to civil power and military aid to civil ministry, which are roles derived from defense instruments. Therefore, we want to state here and now that the history of our revolution cannot be rewritten by those who have not been part of it. Having said that, we strongly urge them, one, to stop reckless utterances by politicians from the ruling party denigrating the military, which is